Welcome to the .NET MAUI Pull Tool Refresh Control tutorial. The Syncfusion .NET MAUI Pull Tool Refresh Control enables refreshing the displayed content with a Pull Tool Refresh action. In this video, I will show you how to add a Syncfusion .NET MAUI Pull Tool Refresh Control to your .NET MAUI application. I'll also demonstrate how to customize the refresh view threshold and pull threshold. Additionally, I will show you how to customize the appearance of the progress bar, programmatically start and stop progress animation, and refresh the view using the command. Before you begin, ensure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the .NET MAUI application. Then, give the project name and location. Next, create a project with the .NET 8.0 framework. Now, the default application is ready to use. Before moving forward, let me take a quick detour to set up the application's environment. I select the Android emulators from this list to see the output in the Pixel 5 emulator. Next, I'll run the application to show you the default output. The application compiles the default code, so wait for a few seconds. Now, the application's home page is displayed. Next, let me show you how to incorporate the Pull Tool Refresh control into this application. I need to install the Syncfusion MAUI Pull Tool Refresh NuGet package, so I open the NuGet package manager and switch to the Browse tab. I search for the Syncfusion MAUI Pull Tool Refresh package, select it, and install it in my project. After the package is installed, I need to register the handler for the Syncfusion core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. I open the MAUI program CS file and add the Syncfusion MAUI core hosting namespace. Then register the Syncfusion core handler by adding the configure Syncfusion core method. Registering a trial license key is necessary to use the Syncfusion MAUI controls. So I open the appsaml cs file and add the register license method with the trial license key. To find out where to generate it, please refer to the instructions link in the description below. Next, I navigate to the main page XAML to initialize the control. I'll remove the default code from the content page section and import the Syncfusion MAUI Pull Tool Refresh namespace. In this example, I will show you how to update the temperature using the Pull Tool Refresh control. First, I'll initialize the vertical stack layout and set its spacing to 10. Within this layout, add the Pull Tool Refresh control, name it Pull Tool Refresh, and set the height request. Then I define the pullable content property to add the content. Next, add a vertical stack layout and set its background color. Inside the layout, add a label to show the header of the content and customize its text, font size, text color, and horizontal text alignment. Similarly, I'll add another label to display the temperature, name it value a label, and set the text to 24 degrees. I customize its font size, text color, horizontal text alignment, and height request. Now I run the application. You can see the temperature value. Once I pull down, you can observe that the temperature value is not updated. To update the temperature value, wire the refreshing event with its event handler method. This event triggers when refresh starts. Now I'll navigate to the main page CS. I create a random class field, an array type temperature values field with 6 values, and an index field to select the temperature value from the array. Then locate the refreshing event handler method and change it to async to set the delay. Inside this method, set pull tool refresh is refreshing property to true to start the animation. Next, set the delay to 1000 milliseconds. Then randomly select the index value from the random field and update the value label text to the temperature value at the index. Finally, set the isRefreshing value to false to stop the animation. Once the application is loaded, pull from the top and you will see the refresh animation and the temperature value updated once the animation is completed. Let me demonstrate how to customize the pulling and refresh view thresholds. The pulling threshold represents the distance of pull action required by the user to trigger data refresh. By default, it is set to 200. To customize it, set the pulling threshold property to 100. The refresh view threshold defines the pull-down movement required to indicate that the user intends to refresh the content. By default, it is set to 50. To customize it, set the refresh view threshold to 25. Now you can see the pulling and refresh view thresholds as you have set them. To customize the refresh transition, set the transition mode to push. The pull-to-refresh control provides two transition modes, slide on top and push, with slide on top being the default mode. Now I pull and you can see the transition push the refresh and main content simultaneously. Now let me show you how to customize the appearance of the progress bar. A progress bar visually represents the completion status of a process. To customize its color, set the progress color to green, progress thickness to 6, and progress background to light green. Look, the progress bar color and thickness are customized. Next, I will show you how to refresh the view using the command. This control provides our refresh command property to refresh the view. To illustrate, I create a new iCommand field named refresh command. Then, within this file, I define a new private asynchronous method named refresh. Next, I implemented the logic used in the refreshing event handler method to update the temperature value once the pull to refresh action is completed. In the constructor, I set the refresh command to new command with the refresh method, and then assign refresh command to the pull to refresh control's refresh command property. Before running the application, ensure that the refreshing event isn't hooked in the main page XAML. Check here, the pull to refresh control is refreshed using the command. Finally, I will show you how to start and stop the refresh animation programmatically. To demonstrate that, I'll add horizontal layout and customize its horizontal options and spacing. Within this layout, add single button, customize the width request, and wire the clicked event. Similarly, add another button and set its text to end. Then, navigate to the main page CS and locate the start button clicked event handler method. Here, call the start refreshing method, which is used to start the progress animation. Next, in the end button clicked event handler method, call the end refreshing method designed to stop animation. Check here, when I tap the start button, the refresh animation starts. When I tap the end button, it stops. In this video, I showed you how to add a Syncfusion .NET MAUI pull to refresh control to your .NET MAUI application. I also demonstrated how to customize the refresh view threshold and pull threshold. Additionally, I showed you how to customize the appearance of the progress, start, and stop the animation programmatically and refresh the view using the refresh command. To learn more about pull to refresh control features, you can check the documentation link in the video description. I have also included a link to check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.